हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन। आई होप यू ऑल आर कंप्लीटिंग योर असाइनमेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू वीडियो लेसन। आई एक्सेप्ट दैट यू ऑल आर कंप्लीटिंग असाइनमेंट एंड सेंडिंग द मैसेज इन ग्रुप। सो चिल्ड्रन, इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैड कंप्लीटेड इन अवर मैथ 11th chapter. Today in this class we will start new chapter, that is 12th one, perimeter and area. So children, before starting perimeter, children, what do you mean by perimeter? Perimeter is the measurement of any diagram which one is given. For example, square. If we will take square, so in square how many sides are there? 4 equal sides are there. Then what will be perimeter? The measurement of all 4 sides. So children, today we are going to study related to perimeter and area. So in our exercise 44 questions are given, that question we will complete. So children, here in question number first, the length and the breadth of a rectangle are double. How many times the perimeter of the old rectangle will that of the new rectangle will be? So children, as I told you in diagram, this one is rectangle A, B, C and D. Here length is this one and this one. That is length AB equal to L we have taken, and breadth AD equal to B we had taken. And property of rectangle, opposite sides of rectangle is equal measurement. That's why this both side is LL. Opposite side of this both sides are equal. Therefore, in rectangle we had taken this side B and B. So children, here it is given perimeter of a rectangle. Write down first question. Perimeter of a rectangle equal to length into breadth. What we will write? Then here one length and here second length. Therefore, we will write 2 length plus 2 breadth. I hope you all got. Here length and length, 2 length, B plus B, 2 breadth. Therefore, perimeter of a rectangle formula is 2 length plus 2 breadth. Now children, here question is given. If length and breadth of a rectangle are double, write down if the length and breadth of a rectangle is double, then children, first try to understand this diagram. Children, here length L was there. Here they are asking to take 2 length. Here also means double, 2 length. Here 2 breadth. Here also 2 breadth. So children, what will be our new perimeter of a rectangle? Write down new perimeter of a rectangle equal to 2 plus 2, 4th L plus 2 plus 2, 4 B. Then from here 4 we can take 2 common. or we can take, because we want 2 length plus 2 breadth. Our formula for perimeter of a rectangle is 2 length plus 2 breadth. Therefore, what we will take? 2L plus 2B. Children, I hope what I told, common we have taken only 2. Why? We can take here 4 also. But in that way, we are not getting our formula. We want, here our question is there, how many times the perimeter of the old rectangle will that of new rectangle? Means how many times? 2 times. Means this one is our perimeter of a rectangle formula. And how many times our new perimeter of a rectangle is from the first one? Then how many times it is? 2 times. Write down, therefore, answer write down 2 times. What you will write? Answer 2 times. I had written this answer in short only. What you will write, children? A new perimeter of a rectangle is 2 times the old one. I hope you all understood. Children, our new perimeter is 4L plus 4B. We have taken common 2 because this one is our old perimeter of a rectangle. Therefore, our old formula 2 length plus 2 breadth, this one, and the new one 2L plus 2B, that is 2 times. Therefore, what is the answer? Our new perimeter of a rectangle is 2 times of old one. Then, now we are going to move for our second question. If the side of a square is tripled. Children, listen properly. In first question, rectangle given. But in second question, square given. And we know about square. So, I will draw first this one. So, children, in question number 2, here perimeter of a square is, first we will write perimeter of a square. Perimeter of a square equal to, if you can, here measurement not given. You can take any variable from A to Z. Suppose we are taking perimeter of a square equal to A. Then here, here directly we are not writing. First we are assuming the side of a square. So children, here first we will write side of a square. From side we will find out perimeter of a square equal to, in our formula, the square, how many sides are there? 4 sides. Therefore, 4 sides, that is 4 into side. So, children, 4 and side is given A. Therefore, 4A. Now, after that, what they told? That how many times the perimeter of the first square will that of the new square? So, here, this one is our perimeter of a square. Here it is. I had not written square. It is understood. Perimeter of a square. That is our formula 4a. But here, the perimeter of new square. Write down. Perimeter of a new square equal to, it's given, side of a square is tripled, means our side. Now side given 3a, tripled, means whatever side A is given, from that triple means 3a. Perimeter of a, now this one, for this one, perimeter of a new square equal to 4 into a. A is what? Side. Then for new perimeter of a square, this one is 3a. Therefore, 4 into 3, 12A. So children, after that, what they want? How many times the perimeter of the first square will that of the new square be? Therefore, here write down perimeter of new square upon perimeter of old square. So children, here per new square 12a and the old square 4a. A cancelled. 4 1 4, 4 3 12. So children, here our answer is 3. Then how many times new one is from more than that is 3 times the new square perimeter is, write down perimeter of new square is 3 times more. Perimeter of new square is 3 times more than old square. Here you can continue than old square. I hope everyone understood related to our rectangle and square. For rectangle, I told you perimeter of rectangle is 2 length plus 2 breadth. And perimeter of square is 4 into side, that is 4a, or whatever your side will be there, 4 into that side. So children, now question number 3. Given along side is the diagram of a playground. It shows the length of its side. Find the perimeter of the playground. So first we will draw the diagram. Question number 3rd one. In question number 3rd one, here diagram is given. So children, here equal, that is here it is given 15 meter. This one given 5 meter. This one given 15 meter. And this one given 10 meter. So children, here from this figure we are going to find out perimeter of playground. Then write down perimeter of playground equal to, children see here, this one is 15 and this one is 15, and here till here if you will continue, then this one is 15 and this one is 15, isn't it? Now next one, children, here 5 meter given and here 10 meter given, including both this one is given, isn't it? Therefore this one is 15 meter. So what we will write? 10 meter, first write down 10 meter plus 15 meter plus 5 meter plus, there this here place is not there, that's why I am writing here, plus 15 meter plus this 15 meter plus this both 15 15, 30 meter, correct? No, I am writing together 30 meter. So children, what will be our answer here? This one 15, this one 15, 15 15 30. So here 30 and this including this one 30, correct? What is remain? This 15 plus 5, or you can take 10 plus 5 15 plus this one 15. So children, here 30 plus 30 60 meter plus 15 plus 15 30 मीटर. सो 60 प्लस 30 90 मीटर. सो चिल्ड्रन द पेरीमीटर ऑफ प्ले ग्राउंड इज 90 मीटर. आई होप एवरी वन अंडरस्टूड द डायग्राम एज वेल एज हाउ वी फाइंड आउट द पेरीमीटर ऑफ दिस प्ले ग्राउंड. यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 4th. एंड सो इन द फिगर 4 नैपकिन्स ऑल ऑफ द सेम साइज वेर मेड फ्रॉम ए स्क्वायर पीस ऑफ क्लोथ ऑफ लेंथ 1 मीटर. वॉट लेंथ ऑफ लेस विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू ट्रिम ऑल 4 साइड ऑफ ऑल द नैपकिन. सो चिल्ड्रन हियर मीनिंग ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन. चिल्ड्रन 1 स्क्वायर मीटर क्लोथ दे हैड टेकन एंड दैट स्क्वायर मीटर क्लोथ 1 मीटर स्क्वायर क्लोथ दे हैड डिवाइडेड इनटू 4 पार्ट्स. देन फ्रॉम 1 मीटर फर्स्ट व्हाट दे विल डू हाफ एंड फ्रॉम दैट हाफ आल्सो दैट दे हैड डिवाइडेड दिस लेंथ आल्सो एंड द ब्रेथ आल्सो. दैट इज सपोज 1 मीटर लेंथ. Then when they had made that half, then it is converted into 1 upon 2. Again, that this side, same 1 meter only, because it is square, then it is again half only. Therefore, from 1 meter cloth, how many handkerchief they had prepared? 4 handkerchief. And now, they cut the 4 handkerchief from cloth and now they want to put lace outside of that handkerchief. Then how many lace we require? So children, here for fourth question. Question number 4th one. Fourth one. First we will write here 4 handkerchief. That is 4 handkerchief of equal size. Therefore, first we will write length of a square piece of cloth. Length of a square piece of a cloth equal to 1 meter, correct? Because it is given in your question. Length of a square piece of cloth is 1 meter. After that, what we had done, from that 1 meter measurement, it is cut from in between. Then it will convert into half of meter. Therefore, write down length of a square napkin equal to half meter, correct? No? Now length of a square napkin equal to half meter. 1 meter divided into 2 parts, that's why half meter. Now third point, what we will write? Perimeter of a square napkin equal to, children, pay attention here, perimeter and square. For square, what we are writing? 4 into side. Then here side is what? Half meter, therefore. And for perimeter of a square, what we are writing? 4. Therefore, 4 into side is half. Therefore, your answer 2 1 2, 2 2 4 means 2 meter. So children, here what else we required? Here we this one is the lace for 1 handkerchief. Now we want 4 side of all the napkin. Therefore, we want perimeter of 4 square napkin equal to 4. And for one square napkin we want 2 meter. Therefore, 4 square napkin we required. Perimeter of 4 square napkin we required. We required number of layers equal to 4 into 2 meter equal to 8 meter. Here for perimeter of, or if we want what length of lace will be required to trim all 4 sides of all the napkin. Here perimeter of all 4 instead of square you can write 4 side square napkin. We required number of lace equal to, for one napkin we required the lace of 2 meter. Therefore for 4 handkerchief we required the number of lace equal to 4 into 2 meter, that is 8 meter. If you want, then what you will write, children? Suppose we are writing, then we will write perimeter of 4 side square napkin, that is 8 meter. So children, what we had done today, whatever we learned, I hope you all understood. So children, whatever today we had discussed, according to that I had put the assignment question, and I expect that you all will able to solve all the question. So children, related to this 4 question, if any doubt is there, you can clear your doubt with the help of subject teacher. So children, be safe, healthy and happy. God bless you children. Thank you.